going on, guys? Today I'm doing a tutorial on the corkscrew. The reason why I chose to do a tutorial is because I haven't done one in a while and it's been suggested that I do a cork tutorial. Now, just before I get into it, I want to let you know that corks are not an easy move. I mean, they're easy to try but also easy to stuff up. And it takes a long time to actually master a cork. When I mean master, I mean be able to get out of bed and chuck a cork straight away.
Alrighty, so the first step to the cork is your runner, whether it would be this kind of runner, or whether it being a J-step, which I find works better, and that goes like that. So, the one I suggest using is the J-step, because you get more power and more height, but in the end it's really up to you what you want to do. So yeah, either that one, or this one. I'll just give you a quick demonstration of a cork so you know exactly what I'm talking about. I'm going to do a cork with this runner and with the J-step. That's the J-step. So for the timing, once you get to this point and you're about to take off, you want to have your arms right back with your leg right back as well. Then you want to swing your leg through with your arms, like that. You want to kick this leg as much as you can, because that will generate the spin. And swing your arms up, that will give you height. And once you feel this foot come off the ground, bring them in, so you can spin. So just a quick little slow-mo demonstration, so you can see what I'm talking about. Okay, just if you missed anything, I'm going to recap over everything. So, runner has got to be powerful. You've got to have some purpose with it, otherwise you're not going to make it around. So either J-step, or this one. Whichever one you want to do. I'm going to show the J-step because that's how I do it. Now, it's got to be really powerful, so you've got to go. It's got to be that powerful. You can't afford to do little steps, because that just won't work. Give a demonstration quick of a little step, like not even trying a cork. This is what it looks like. So we don't want that happening, yes? So you got to make your run up power. So just a quick thing about the landing. So it's a bit hard to demonstrate, but be up in the air, and twisting, and then once you've done your 360, you like this leg out and that leg out to land. I'll just give it a slow mo so you might get an idea of what I'm talking about. All about kicking that leg out at the end. That'll cause you to land. Don't try and land like your feet together, because that's actually pretty hard. Just start off landing on one leg and then having the other one. Now, I thought I might add this little part in. It's just if you don't get the spin, like if you don't get how to do the spin, it's really easy, but I'll just give you a quick like, overview of how you actually do the spin. Put your foot there, and go like that, and it's pretty hard to backflip 360, but yeah, if you're struggling to get the spin, just do this little bit. You want to make sure you're going in that way, not like out some other way, definitely. So yeah, just a little bit. Now if you're scared to commit, unless you're scared of Max, put it there, and yeah, you just got to go through it. You can't up outline on it with a mat, you kind of just go like this. You just get it higher and higher, so you can do a cork. bit of safety, like I said, don't go doing it out on concrete or anything stupid like that until you've mastered it. So I don't want to be responsible for any injuries that might occur to you, so yeah, keep that in mind. Thanks for watching this video, guys. I really appreciate it. Make sure to leave a thumbs up and comment down below. Tell me what you thought of the video. Right, see you in the next one.